This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Old Saxon, also known as Old Low German, is a Germanic language and the earliest recorded form of Low German. It belongs to the West Germanic branch and is most closely related to the Anglo-Frisian languages. It is documented from the 8th century until the 12th century, when it evolved into Middle Low German. It was spoken on the northwest coast of Germany and in the Netherlands by Saxon peoples. It is close enough to Old Anglo-Frisian Old Frisian, Old English, that it partially participates in the Ingvaeonic nasal spirant law. It is also closely related to Old Dutch. The grammar of Old Saxon was fully inflected with 5 grammatical cases: nominative, accusative, genitive, dative, and instrumental, 3 grammatical numbers singular, plural, and dual, and 3 grammatical genders masculine, feminine, and neuter. The dual forms occurred in the first and second persons only and referred to groups of 2 for a long time. Old Saxon and Old Dutch were not distinguished and often thought to be different dialects of the same language. However, while these two languages both shared the same historical origins and some very similar writing styles, Old Saxon shows a slightly reduced morphology compared to Old Dutch, which kept some grammatical distinctions that Old Saxon abandoned. There are also various differences in their phonological evolutions, Old Saxon being considered as an Ingvaeonic language whereas Old Dutch as an Istvaeonic language contents. 1 characteristics 11 relation with other West Germanic languages 12 relation to Middle Low German 2 phonology 21 early developments 22 consonants 23 vowels 24 diphthongs 3 grammar 31 morphology 32 nouns 33 verbs 34 syntax 4 orthography 5 literature 6 text sample 7 see also 8 notes 9 bibliography 91 sources 92 general 93 lexicons 94 external history 10 external links characteristics relation with other West Germanic languages area in which Old Saxon was spoken in Yellow Old Saxon or Old Low German probably evolved primarily from Ingvaeonic dialects in the West Germanic branch of Proto-Germanic in the 5th century. However, Old Saxon, even if it is considered as an Ingvaeonic language, is not a pure Ingvaeonic dialect as Old Frisian and Old English are, the two latter sharing some other Ingvaeonic characteristics, like the great vowel shift that took place in both Old English and Old Frisian. This, plus the large number of different forms that the language took, often showing different West Germanic features, led some philologists to mistakenly think that Old Dutch and Old Saxon were variations of the same language, and that Old Saxon was indeed an Istvaeonic language in the Middle Ages. A dialect continuum existed between Old Dutch and Old Saxon. This was only recently interrupted by the simultaneous dissemination of standard languages within each nation and the dissolution of folk dialects. Despite sharing some features, a number of disparities separate Old Saxon, Old English, and Old Dutch. One such difference is the Old Dutch utilization of a as its plural, a stem noun ending, while Old Saxon and Old English employ as or os. However, it seems that some Middle Dutch took the Old Saxon a stem ending from some Middle Low German dialects, as modern Dutch still shows the plural ending s added to certain words. Words relation to Middle Low German Old Saxon naturally evolved into Middle Low German during the 12th century, but the evolution from Old Saxon towards Middle Low German was long and uninterrupted. Main article, Old Saxon phonology early developments. Old Saxon did not participate in the High German consonant shift, and thus preserves stop consonants p, t, k that have been shifted in Old High German to various fricatives and affricates. The Germanic diphthongs I, o consistently develop into long vowels e, o, whereas in Old High German they appear either as a, o or e, o depending on the following consonant. Old Saxon, alone of the West Germanic languages except for Frisian, consistently preserves Germanic j after a consonant, e.g. Heliand savior, Old High German, Highland, Old English, Helland, Gothic, Halion Germanic umlaut, when it occurs with short a, is inconsistent, e.g. Hebian or Habian to have Old English, Haben. This feature was carried over into the descendant language of Old Saxon, Middle Low German, where e.g. the adjective crank sick, ill had the comparative forms cranker and cranker apart from the e. However, the umlaut is not marked in writing consonants. The table below lists the consonants of Old Saxon phonemes written in parentheses represent allophones and are not independent phonemes. Old Saxon consonant phonemes: labial dental, alveolar palatal velar glottal nasal mn plosive voiceless ptk voiced bd, x. Fricative sibilant s, z non-sibilant f v theta, h approximant l j w rhotic r notes, the voiceless spirants, f, theta, and, s, gain voiced allophones, and when between vowels this change is only faithfully reflected in writing for represented with letters such as and u the other two allophones continued to be written as before. Fricatives were devoiced again word finally beginning in the later Old Saxon period, stops became devoiced word finally as well most consonants could be geminated notably, geminated, v, gave, bb, and geminated, probably gave, geminated, h, resulted in, xx, Germanic h is retained as in these positions and thus merges with devoiced, vowels Old Saxon monophthongs front back unrounded rounded short long short long short long close. I, y, u close mid e e o stroke o open mid, o. Near open a ash open, notes, long vowels were rare in unstressed syllables and mostly occurred due to suffixation or compounding diphthongs Old Saxon diphthongs front opening I o. Probably under the influence of Franconian or High German dialects, where they replace Old Saxon developments, and, which evolved from Proto-Germanic, I, and, O, the situation for the front opening diphthongs is somewhat unclear in some texts words written with I-O in the Heliand, the most extensive record of Old Saxon writing, are often found written variably with Ia or even IE in most other texts, notably the later ones the diphthong eventually merges into, E, in almost every Middle Low German dialect there also existed, long, diphthongs, o u, a u, and e u. These were, however, treated as two-syllable sequences of a long vowel followed by a short one, not proper diphthongs. Grammar main article, Old Saxon grammar morphology. Unlike modern English, but like Old English, Old Saxon is an inflected language, rich in morphological diversity. It kept several distinct cases from Proto-Germanic, the nominative, accusative, genitive, dative, and vestigially in oldest texts. Instrumental Old Saxon also had three grammatical numbers singular, plural, and dual and three grammatical genders masculine, feminine, and neuter. The dual forms occurred in the first and second persons only and referred to groups of two nouns. Old Saxon nouns were inflected in very different ways following their classes. Here are the endings for dag, day, and a stem masculine noun, dag, day, m case singular plural nominative dag, dagos accusative dag, dagos genitive dages, as dago dative dage, a dagum, un. At the end of the Old Saxon period, distinctions between noun classes began to disappear, and endings from one were often transferred to the other declension, and vice versa. This happened to be a large process, and the most common noun classes started to cause the least represented to disappear as a result. In Middle Low German, only the former weak end stem and strong a stem classes remained. These two noun inflection classes started being added to words not only following the historical belonging of this word, but also following the root of the word verbs. The Old Saxon verb inflection system reflects an intermediate stage between Old English and Old Dutch, and further Old High German. Unlike Old High German and Old Dutch, but similarly to Old English, it did not preserve the three different verb endings in the plural, all featured as ad, also iad or iod following the different verb inflection classes. Like Old Dutch, it had only two classes of weak verb, with only a few relic verbs of the third weak class, namely four verbs, libion, segion, hugion and hebion. This table sums up all the seven Old Saxon strong verb classes and the three weak verb classes, strong verbs, weak verbs. Conjugation pronoun to ride, to fly, to help, to break, to speak, to travel, to wield, to deem, to declare, to say, infinitive reiden fliogen helpen brecken spreken. Faren walden domian malen segion present indicative ik ridu flugu hilpu briku spriku feru waldu domio malen seju tu. Redis flugis hilpis brikis spricus ferris weldus domus malo sages he, it, su ridid flugid hilpid bricid spricid ferid welded. Domid malid saged y per gram I, sia redod flyagod helpad brecid sprecid ferid waldad domiad malid segiod past indicative ik red flog. Halp brak sprak for weld domda maloda sagda tu redi flugi hulpi braki spraki fori weldi domdis malods. Sagd is he, it, su red flog halp brak sprak for weld domda maloda sagda y per gram I, sia ridden flugen hulpen bracken spraken. Foren welden domden malodun sagden present subjunctive ik ride flioge help breke spreke fair wald domi malo segi tu. Rides flioges helps brekes spreeks fares walds domis malos segis he, it, su ride flioge help breke spreke fair wald. Domi malo segi y per gram I, sia riden flyagen helpen brecken sprecken faren walden domian malian segin past subjunctive ik ridi flugi. Hulpi brachi spraki fori weldi domdi maladi sagdi tu ridis flugis hulpis brachis sprakis foris weldis domdis malodis. Sagdis he, it, su ridi flugi hulpi brachi spraki fori weldi domdi maladi sagdi y per gram I, sia riden flugen hulpen bracken spraken. Foren welden domden maloden sagden imperative singular rid flyog help brek sprek far wald domi malo sage plural. Redod flyagod helpad breked spreked farad waldad domiad malyad segiad present participle redondi flyagondi helpondi brekandi sprekandi farundi waldandi. Domiandi malandi segiandi past participle giridan giflogan gihulpan gibroken gisprekan gifaron givalden gidamit gimalad gisagd. It should be noticed that the third weak verb class includes only four verbs, namely libion, segion, hugion, and hebion. It is a remnant of an older and larger class that was kept in Old High German syntax. Old Saxon syntax is mostly different from that of English. Some were simply consequences of the greater level of nominal and verbal inflection. Will be kept, and the sounds modern scholars have traditionally assigned to these letters where spelling deviations in other texts may point to significant pronunciation variants. This will be indicated in general. The spelling of Old Saxon corresponds quite well to that of the other ancient Germanic languages, such as Old High German or Gothic. C and K were both used for however, it seems that, as in other West Germanic dialects, when was followed by I or E, it had the pronunciation, TS, or, KS. The letters C and X were preferred for the palatal K and even sometimes CH being rather used before U, O or A for K, kuning for king, modern koning. Ik, ir, year, ku and KW always represents, kwamen they came, S represented, and between two vowels also TH is used to indicate, thoten they thought, is used for, occasionally also written DHU represented the vowels and or the consonant which was usually written with, UU was normally used to represent, predating the letter WZ only appeared in a few texts due to Old High German influence literature. Heliand excerpt from the German Historical Museum. Only a few texts survive, predominantly baptismal vows. The Saxons were required to perform at the behest of Charlemagne. The only literary texts preserved are Heliand and fragments of the Old Saxon Genesis. Heliand beta homily homily betas credo abrenunciatio diaboli et credo Old Saxon baptismal vow Old Saxon Genesis fragments. Essener Hebiregister Old Saxon baptismal vow German, Saxisches Taufgelobnis Penitentiary Westfalisch Beicht Trier Blutzigen des Sprachals Wiener Furzigen de Wormsigen Wiener Wormsigen de Psalms Commentary Gernroder Psalmenkommenters Text Sample. A poetic version of the Lord's Prayer in the form of the traditional Germanic alliterative verse is given in Old Saxon below as it appears in the Heliand line original translation. Fadar USA Fariho Barno, Father of Us, the Sons of Men, Tu bist in them Hohen Himmela Rikea, you are in the high heavenly kingdom, Guahid si thin namo uordo gehu iliko. Blessed be your name in every word special word, kuma thin kraftag riki may your mighty kingdom come uera thin uilio or thessa world Allah, may become your will be done over all this world, so sama an arrow, so thar upa east just the same on earth, as just like it is up there in them hohen himilo rikea in the high heavenly kingdom in the kingdom of the heavens gef us dag gehuilikes rad, droten the godo, give us support advices, counsels each day, good chieftain chieftain, lord the good, thina heliga helpa, endi alat us, heens you Lord, your holy help, and pardon us, protector Lord, ruler of heaven, Manigoro Menscudio, of our many crimes, also ue orum manum don just as we do to other human beings to other men. Ne latus faraldin li uuihti do not let evil little creatures lead us off cause us to leave so for an iro uuilian, so ui urige sin, to do to go on with their will, as we deserve, ac help us ui are all in uilin dadian but help us to fight against all evil deeds. See also Middle Ages Portal Germany Portal Languages Portal Old Saxon Genesis Old Saxon Baptismal Vow Heliand Middle Low German Ingvaeonic Nasal Spirant Law Notes Carrot Hammerstrom, Harold, Forkel, Robert, Haspelmath. Martin, Bank, Sebastian, eds 2016 Old Saxon, Glottolog 27 Jena, Max Planck Institute for the Science of Human History. I'm 7 Jahrhundert, Analyse und Reconstruction West Germanic, from its emergence in the 3rd up until its dissolution in the 7th century CE, Analyses and Reconstruction 244p, in German with English summary, London, Berlin 2013, ISBN 978-3-981211-0-7-8 Roch, Ermengarde 1992 The Old Saxon Language Berkeley Models of Grammar, Peter Lang Publishing. Meidinger, Heinrich 1923 Vergleichens Etymologisches Wörterbuch der Gothisch Teutonischen Mundarten Ulan Press. East Elbe Weser Rhine North Sea Reconstructed Proto-Germanic Proto-Germanic Grammar Germanic Parent Language Historical Languages North Proto-Norse Old Norse Old Swedish Old Gutnish Norn Greenlandic Norse Old Norwegian Middle Norwegian East Gothic Crimean Gothic Vandalic Burgundian West Old Saxon Middle Low German Old High German Middle High German Frankish Old Dutch Middle Dutch Old Frisian Middle Frisian Old English Middle English Early Scots Middle Scots Lombardic 4th and Bargi Fingalian Modern Languages Afrikaans Alemannic Danish Dutch English Faroese German Gutnish Icelandic Limburgish Low German Mennonite Low German Luxembourgish